guys, it's Christy. I'm here to do a haul for you. There's going to be some Ulta going on. I guess y'all can hear the bag. So I'm going to show you what I've picked up since the last time I did a haul. And I'll go ahead and start with this couple little things over here that are kind of boring. Well, this one is boring. I went back and got myself some Listerine toothpaste. I've used this forever and ever. And if you watch my empties, you already know that. But what I do, because I'm a weirdo, is I put this with Sensodyne. And for some reason, I don't know why I need two toothpastes, but that's just how I do it. Well, I tried to just use one toothpaste, and I'm going through withdrawal, so I had to go back and get some Listerine. So I picked that up. And then I was in Marshall's, and I picked up this loofah exfoliating scrub. What's this in? This is from Earth Therapeutics. And it says it's originally $8. I got it for $3.99. It smells pretty good. I like it. I haven't used it yet. I don't know if I actually like it, but I like the smell of it. I'll try anything once. Twice if I don't get hurt too bad the first time trying it. Okay. So, I got one of the new Kate Moss lipsticks. And I got this at Meijer, but you can get it anywhere. Those bags are so loud. And it's really pretty. These are matte. That's why I only got one. I'm trying to accept the matte lipstick trend right now. So this is in 102. And it's really pretty. It's just kind of like a pink. That's what it looks like. And then, let's go ahead and get this bag out of the way. It's just driving me crazy. This bag has some exciting stuff in it. I got this stuff from Ulta. I haven't tried any of this. Okay, I'll go ahead and show you the nail polishes I got. This is in Butler Please. It's a really pretty blue from Essie. And then this is Butterfly Moment from OPI. And this is, I think Mariah Carey's line, I believe. And with that, I got this fabulous glitter. What's the name of this? Pink Yet Lavender. And it's got a lot of hexagons in it that are pink. And then some I wouldn't even call it micro glitter. It's pretty small, but it's not. Well, yeah, I guess it would. Let's call it that. In silver. It's just really pretty. I like it. The exciting thing, though, from this is these two products. And these are from L'Oreal Paris. And these are supposedly dupes for the YSL Glossy Stains. This one, and I haven't tried them yet, is in 190 Endless Red. See, the applicator is pretty much the same. I mean, it's pretty close. And that's what that looks like. Let's see. It does have a scent to it. A little bit of a chemically scent. Or chemical scent. Chemically scent. And maybe a little bit of flower. I can deal with it. I can deal with anything if I can deal with those YSL glosses. Those things stink to high heaven. And this one is in number 184, Rose On and On. Yep, they smell the same. So that's the color of that. So these are supposed to be dupes for those YSL Glossy Stains. So we'll have to see what the staying power is and things like that. And the YSL Glossy Stains, I mean, they're going to get you through. Yeah, they stain. They get you through about 4 to 6 hours. Yeah, right around there. The next thing that I got was from Rite Aid. One was a nail polish, and this is a limited edition nail polish in Rose Bling. And it's It's a Maybelline polish, and it's got pink hexagons and some pink micro glitter. And sometimes when you turn it, it looks like those hexagons are going a deep pink too. So it's really pretty, and I think it'll go really well with this other polish that I picked up from OPI. And then Physicians Formula has come out with a couple of new products. They are doing BB creams now. So this is their all-in-one super BB cream. That's what that looks like. And this came with, these are 40% off at Rite Aid this week. And this one came with a $3 off coupon. And then they have an all-in-one beauty balm powder. And this one also came with a $3 off coupon. You know, actually, I think it was the powder that was 40% off. I think this was 40% off too. I hate how they do that. They don't do like 40% off the whole line. They will every now and then, but a lot of times it's, you know, just eye stuff or just bronzers or just face powders. That's how they do it. So you get up to the front and you get ready to pay and you're like, well, I don't want it if it's not 40% off. I mean, you don't say it's snotty because you have to go back to the Rite Aid, you know. You just don't want to have to go back in there if everybody hates you. But they actually really like the people that work at my Rite Aid. They're really nice to me. They see me all the time. So they're just like, okay. And they'll even ask me when they see it before, if it's not on sale, do you not want it? You know, when it rings. Because that's what I'm there for. I'm there for the sale. I want the deal. And I know next week they're going to be running probably buy one, get one half off. Or in about 3 weeks they'll run, you know, buy one, get one free. Or they're all time running something. For books, this is Murder on Washington Square by Victoria Thompson. That's the next one in the series that I'm reading, those Gaslight books. And then, I can't say that this is good. I've just read the first chapter, which I liked, but I can't tell you for sure this next book until I get done. But when I was ordering, Skabadi, when I was ordering on Amazon, you know how like you go in and you place your order and then they say people who ordered this also ordered this? Well, that's how I found this. And this is called Maids of Misfortune. And it's a historic novel based in Victorian era San Francisco. And it's a mystery. And this widow owns a boarding house. So I am just into the first chapter. Did you hear him? He's rotten. I'm just into the first chapter. So far, I really like it. This is a series, so obviously I'll keep going, and I'll let you guys know. I'll have read probably, well, for sure, finish this by the time I do my next favorite, so I'll kind of let you know what it's about. And I guess I could just go ahead and read the back of it to you so you would know. It's the summer of 1979, and Annie Fuller, a young San Francisco widow, is in trouble. Annie's husband squandered her fortune before committing suicide 5 years earlier. That was nice, wasn't it? And one of his creditors is now threatening to take the boarding house she owns to pay off a debt. Annie Fuller also has a secret. She supplements her income by giving domestic violence. Yeah, she might do that too, I don't know. By giving domestic and business advice to Madam Sybil, one of San Francisco's most exclusive clairvoyants, and one of Madame Sybil's clients, Matthew Voss, has died. We haven't gotten there yet in the book. I haven't gotten as far as the death. The police believe his death was a suicide brought upon by bankruptcy. But Annie believes Voss has been murdered and that his assets have been stolen. Nate Dawson has a problem. As the Voss family lawyer, he would love to believe that Matthew Voss didn't leave his grieving family destitute, wouldn't we all? And that would mean working with Annie Fuller, a woman who alternately attracts and infuriates him as she shatters every notion he ever had of proper ladylike behavior. Sparks fly as Annie and Nate pursue the truth about the murder of Matthew Voss in a light-hearted historical mystery set in the foggy, gaslit world of Victorian San Francisco. So, I think this is going to be really good, and I like historical novels, and I like anything in the Victorian era. So, that's my haul. I'm looking forward to the new stuff coming out for spring. Kind of keep up with the videos, and then also check out my blog and all that stuff. That's linked below. Follow me on Twitter. And the 28th of this month, I will have my first YouTube anniversary. So we're gonna have some exciting things coming up for that. So kind of stay tuned. I've got a pretty good idea of what it's gonna be, and I'm working on that. Before I tell you for sure, I want to get everything situated. So it was good to talk to you guys. I hope you enjoyed this haul. Let me know what you guys have picked up, if you've got any ideas of something I might want to try, or books I want to read, or anything like that. I hope you guys have an awesome day, and I'll talk to you later. Thanks. Bye.